What's up guys, my name is Rafal from OPT, and in this video, I'm gonna show you how to get started in astrophotography using the Skywatcher Star Adventurer mount. This mount is widely used by everyone, from beginners looking to take their Milky Way photos to the next level, to professionals with years of deep sky experience under their belts because it is so easy to set up and use. And best of all, it delivers incredible results when it is paired with the right camera and the right lens. It runs on 4 AA batteries, so you never have to worry about your rechargeable batteries running out of juice as long as you have spare batteries with you. And a new pack of batteries can last you as long as 72 hours. And if you want to take batteries completely out of the equation, you could run the tracker from an external power source with the USB connection on the side. I personally started using this tracker a month ago and I was able to capture these awesome images of Comet Neowise, the Andromeda Galaxy, and Ro, all with my mirrorless camera, a 50mm or an 85mm. For larger targets like the Milky Way, you can go a little wider with something like a 14mm, but if you're aiming for something more detailed like the Andromeda Galaxy or Ro, you can go a little tighter with something like an 85mm or even a 200mm. Before you start shooting, you wanna make sure that your tripod and your tracker are both level. And thankfully, the tracker has a built-in bubble level to tell you. One of the most important things in astrophotography is your polar alignment. If your tracker is not properly aligned, then it can't accurately move with the rotation of the Earth, and it's gonna likely leave you with images that have star trails. So, in order to get polar aligned, the first thing we need to do is figure out our latitude. Most apps that tell you your location will work. I'm using the Skywatcher app, so I'm just gonna turn on location, and it's gonna tell me that I'm at 34 degrees above the horizon. So, I'm going to adjust my tracker right here on the wedge with this knob to match my latitude. The next step is to find Polaris, and there are a couple of ways you could do this. You can use an app like Sky Safari, Stellarium, or Skywalk, point your phone at the sky and it's gonna tell you where Polaris is, so that way you can start aligning. Otherwise, you could find it yourself by first looking up and finding the Big Dipper. Once you find it, you can use the two stars at the far end of the cup to point you towards Polaris. Once you found it, you wanna look through the polar scope and get your rough alignment by using the Alt-As and Lat screws to move Polaris close to the center of the polar scope. Then it's time to pull out your polar clock and see where Polaris should be placed depending on your time and location. Polaris is not the exact center of the North Celestial Pole, so we're gonna have to fine tune. Again, I'm using the Skywatcher app, so with location turned on, the app will let me know where Polaris should be on the clock for my polar alignment to be precise. If it is completely dark when you are aligning, you can use the included illuminator to shine into your scope to make it easier to see the polar clock to get your alignment better. Just be aware the L bracket can't be attached to your tracker if you're gonna be using the illuminator, so make sure your alignment is done first before attaching your camera. Once you are polar aligned, it is finally time to start attaching your camera. I'm gonna be using a Canon Rebel T3i, and because I'm shooting the Milky Way, I'm gonna be using a wide 14mm lens. The first thing you're gonna do is take your L bracket and slide it into the dovetail mount, turning the knob to secure it in place. Next, we're gonna attach our counterweight. Always attach your counterweights first before attaching your scope or your camera. Next, you're gonna attach your camera to the declination plate at the top. We recommend having a ball head attachment to get your camera pointed exactly where you want in the sky. Your rig won't be balanced at this point. So to balance it, you're gonna wanna loosen the clutch on the mounting platform, then loosen the knob on your counterweight and adjust it until the rig doesn't move when you let go. If the rig is still unbalanced after the counterweight has been moved all the way to the end of the metal rod, then the entire dovetail needs to be adjusted. Lock your clutch, loosen the knob on the dovetail, and slide it down to add more weight away from your camera. Then tighten the screw, loosen the clutch again, and try to balance one more time. Finally, after your rig is balanced and your tracker is aligned, there's only one last thing to do, and that's to aim your camera at the target. Like I said, I wanted to shoot the Milky Way, so I pointed my camera at the sky and framed my shot up until I got something I liked. All that's left to do is to turn the dial to stellar tracking, and the tracker will start following the stars, keeping my shot in the frame without drifting. Now, some cameras have built-in time-lapse features, but if yours doesn't, you're gonna need to get an intervalometer. These can be found on Amazon for a couple of bucks, but they are crucial to making sure that your camera is taking multiple photos for you. An intervalometer lets you tell your camera how many exposures you want to take, how long you want your exposures to be, and how long your camera should wait in between each photo. It's a good idea to wait between 2 and 5 seconds between each photo to make sure that your camera is finished writing the previous photo before snapping the next one. You don't want your camera to stop taking photos in the middle of your imaging because it hasn't finished writing all the photos onto the card yet. With the 500 rule, I would only be able to get just above 22 second long exposures with a 14mm lens. With a 50mm, that changes to 6 seconds, and with an 85mm, that changes to 4 seconds. These exposure times will vary depending on your sensor size, but because my T3i has an APS-C crop sensor, these are the times I have to work with. But because I'm using the Star Adventurer, I'm able to make these exposures 1 minute, 2 minutes, even 3 minutes long. So before we start tracking, I want to show you guys the different settings this tracker has. Right now it's turned off, but because I'm going to be tracking the Milky Way tonight, I'm going to turn this dial to stellar tracking so that way it tracks the stars. But let's say I wanted to shoot the moon instead of the Milky Way, then the entire process would stay the same. The alignment, the balancing, everything. The only thing I would change is the dial setting right here. So I would change this to lunar tracking so that way the speed of the tracker changes slightly to match the speed of the moon. Now you have a couple of settings on this dial that are a little weird to see, and those are the half time speed all the way to 12 times speed. So why would a tracker have settings that aren't going to match anything you would be shooting in the sky? Simple answer, these settings aren't meant for the sky. You can use these settings for more artistic choices like moving time lapses. Just because this is a sky tracker doesn't mean you always have to track the sky with it. Here's a quick time lapse I made of LA during sunset using this tracker, so it can be useful even in the daytime. So as a quick review, here are the steps to using a Star Adventurer. Number one, make sure your tripod and your tracker are level. Number two, use an app to find out your latitude and set your trackers based the same latitude. Number three, after finding Polaris, get your rough alignment and then, using a polar clock, align your tracker with the North Pole to get the most accurate tracking. Number four, mount and balance your camera, making sure that your counterweight gets put on first before your camera. And number five, set up your shot and turn your dial to the setting that matches what you're shooting. Every mount you purchase after the Star Adventurer follows roughly the same process, so this is a great tool to get you started in astrophotography. And if you guys are looking for a great tripod to go along with your mount, you can always check out the Radian Carbon Fiber Tripod, which has a 55-pound load capacity, replaceable top plates for different mounts, and removable rubber and spiked feet for shooting on concrete and grass. All these products and a lot more are available on optcorp.com. If you guys found this video useful, be sure to leave a like and leave your thoughts in the comments below. Remember to subscribe if you haven't already, and we'll be seeing you all in our next adventure. Clear skies.